On a July morning just after sunrise, Tom Ritchie is watching from afar as his crew rounds up more than 700 head of stocker cattle that have been grazing his family's land over the past few months. This is a typical day in the heart of the Highland Ranch Company's shipping season.
Typically, it starts middle of July, July 13th, 14th, 15th, and lasts 3 to 4 weeks typically. We ship 6 days a week, not on Sunday, and we'll ship anywhere from 400 to maybe 1,000 a day. We're primarily a stocker operation. We bring cattle in typically in mid-April and graze them to October. Some of the grazing season is from early or mid-April to mid to end of July, and that's called an early intensive graze. Through the years, we've expanded that. We now have a cow-calf operation here. And but most of our cattle are yearlings. We own our own cattle. We also custom graze. The cattle come from all over, from Nebraska, Missouri, a lot from Kansas, western Kansas. We even have some from Mississippi. The custom grazers, many of them have been with us for over 25 years.
Tom's granddad started raising cattle in this area in the 1950s. Tom says his family is blessed to run cattle in this unique part of the world.
The Flint Hills is a great place for stalker animals, first of all, because of the grass. The grass is the best in the world. So these stalkers will gain and very good and be very hard and ready to go to the feed yard. So buyers love buying cattle out of the Flint Hills because they do very well on feed as well. But bottom line is the grass. It's the best grass in the world. For 3 months out of the year, there's nothing better.
Even as he's shipping stocker cattle, Tom's crew is also working to stockpile that outstanding forage for the months when grazing won't be available.
We put up about 1,000 round bales of brome a year and prairie hay. Typically, I would rather get a little less hay and higher quality, especially for the yearlings, than more hay and less quality.
Tom and Andy both run a lot of cattle out here in the Flint Hills. Beautiful, beautiful country out here. They've done it for a long time, and one thing that they decided to do too was, instead of farming out their hay operation, they decided, hey, let's get it ourselves. So we got into them with balers, tractors, rakes, and swather, W235 swather, and they started going after it. So they've been doing that for quite a few years now.
Hay season can be challenging, but one of the things that does make it a little easier is we have pretty darn good equipment. Prairie Land, John Deere up out of Emporia has helped us a lot. And they're very good. If you do have a problem, they'll be out here within hours typically to help you fix it. But the equipment rarely breaks down. It goes pretty good.
When they're haying, our guys are on call 24/7. Tom Ritchie making those comments about our service department and what we do for them, Tom and Andy Ritchie, it means the world to us because, you know, we really, truly want to be there 100%. If there's a way, we're going to find it. We're going to find it. We're going to find a way to get there.
Putting up 1,000 bales each year, as the Ritchie family does, is no small task. But the John Deere round balers available today make it easier to deliver more consistent, high-quality bales.
One thing about our balers, it makes pretty tight bale. And that's important to us because our hay's kept outside. And so it sheds water better.
For one thing, is you could look at the balers, you see they've got the big tires on them. A lot of potholes, that kind of stuff out in these areas. You know, to keep our equipment running good and very productive, we want to let it float across this ground. These big tires help that float across there. We have wide pickups that can pick up these heavy windrows, and the baler just flat bales.
Because, you know, you want that thing to be tight, hold together. You know, 14, 1500 pound bale is good. You know, we can pick it up with our bale bed. We use a 5 foot wide bale. We can pick it up with a bale bed. We can pick two of them up, take them out, unroll them, and the cattle can eat them out in the pasture. That net wrap holds them together. We cut it off. It's quicker than stringing. I mean, it's a lot quicker.
The net wrap has speeded up. You know, you got an 8 second tie. I mean, that speeds you up if nothing else. Plus, it holds well. Our net wrap sucks it tight, holds it tight, and it preserves that hay a lot longer than with twine, actually. And it's very timely. You can move it quicker, and it keeps the edges from wicking. Does a good job.
Beyond the bales, the Ritchie family also appreciates the value they get from the John Deere tractors they use day in and day out.
I tell you, I like John Deere tractors because they're reliable. I'll be honest, I've only had a few others. These have done better than any of them. They get the job done.
In the Flint Hills area, a lot of our producers really appreciate the John Deere tractors. Number one, their reliability, comfort and convenience of the cab and the tractor operation alone is a really big one with our consumers. They're feeding cattle, they're baling hay, and they need a simple but reliable, comfortable tractor. Looking to be cool in the summer, and they're looking to be warm in the winter. That's what John Deere has to offer.
I would say over the last 15 to 20 years, we've had a strong relationship with Prairie Land, John Deere, and Emporia. Over the last decade, it's really increased as we've acquired more hay equipment.
Yep. When it comes down to it, producers like Tom Ritchie have a lot in common with the John Deere dealers they rely on. Both are counting on the hay and the cattle produced in their part of the world to make their livelihood.
They're feeding the cattle so they can turn around and make a profit from them. They need good quality hay to do it with. The John Deere baler, putting net wrap on it, the Flint Hills hay, makes it all happen.
The Stalker's Creed, buy them cheap, keep them alive, make them big, sell them high. So, yeah, if all those things work, you make money every year. There's always one of those that fall out. Hopefully you still make money. At least enough to feed the kids, huh?
That's good insight from those who make their living on the land. In the Flint Hills of Kansas, I'm Brian Baxter reporting for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.